typical if I'm having a bad day or things like that, or having a bad month even, I'm able to, for maybe a scene, two scenes, I'm able to step on a stage and be someone else. I'm able to step on a stage and leave everything that I need to leave behind. Acting has allowed me to not be myself. My parents have always been the most supportive people in probably the whole world. I have an extreme, deep passion for soccer that has run about the same amount of time that I've been acting. If I didn't have acting and if I didn't have soccer, I wouldn't be the person I am today. I really want to do this for the rest of my life. I discovered my first love for acting when I did a musical, Oliver, when I was about 5 or 6 years old. And the moment that really captured me loving acting was the first standing ovation, not that I received, but someone else received. And just to see, to be able to watch the audience more than be a part of it was the first time I fell in love with acting. My mom used to dance, and I think that's where I drew a lot of my love for performing, but I think a lot of it also came from my dad, and through, not him actually, he also acted a little bit, but he was more of a soccer player, but it was more of his character, an open character, that kind of, you know, the way he presented himself to people, kind of, you know, was just very accepting, and then for him to be accepting of me doing acting when he loved soccer as well, and to let me do both was also, you know, really big. In middle school, it was very hard to do acting because to be an actor, to do things like that, you were known as gay, and you know, that's a typical stereotype thrown around a lot these days, but it's not true, but my friends have come along since I've come into high school, and since they've matured, things have gotten more supportive every day. My first dance teacher, she was, when I was about 5 years old, she saw me act when I was just in class, you know, practicing dancing, and she would just see me do random things that I would do by myself, and she always encouraged me, and then I never really had anyone really push me until I came here, and it was in middle school when Mr. Holes first saw me act and my crazy bundle of myself. He really took me in, and he, no matter how full of myself I was, or out with, you know, just a lot of energy, he always had patience for me. And I guess he's been very significant, but then it moves to Kathy, and Kathy has, she's pushed me. She's pushed me to know that I really want to do this for the rest of my life, because it was always teetering on the edge, but the way she's talked about it, the way she's given me roles to perform and things to think about. She's made me challenge myself and put it to a challenge of myself of whether I'm ready to do this and if I really want to do this. And I would say probably the most significant has been her in my development for love of acting and wanting to pursue this for a very, very long time. She's really sparked it and really kept it alight, basically. My acting routine involves a lot of talking to myself, whether it's in front of a mirror or just at home with a script. I do a lot of thinking as well. It sounds very weird, but sometimes I'll sit at home and or I'll be in the shower and I'll do nothing but sit there and think about how my character will wash his hair. I will take the shampoo and I will wash my hair maybe 5-6 times how I think that character will wash his hair. What I'll do is when most of the time people aren't looking, I'll start walking like my character. The role that most fascinated me so far has been Joe Ferrone in Up the Down Staircase.
All right, Paige.
The thing that most intrigued me about it was it's the farthest thing that I've had to play for myself in a long time. I've had to, what I did preparing for the role is I had to strip myself down from everything and have to base my whole character off an emotion. And I began to bases this character off an emotion of anger, of being angry at the world and different stuff like that, but it evolved into being confused and being confused about a lot of things. And that was hard for me because I had to walk with swagger of, you know, being helpless but still not caring about anything, you know, and not giving caring about anyone and just walking by them and not caring if I push someone in the hallway or if I do that, which now, you know, I do care if I knock someone over in the hallway. I had to bring myself to the point of the person that I'd never want to be.
Where do you go from here?
Well, I will be attending NYU Tisch, so hopefully that'll be 4 years unless they kick me out. 4 years at NYU Tisch. And then after that, I guess it's hitting the pavement, really, of going to auditions and different stuff like that. Ten years from now, funny enough, simple, but I want to be happy, so wherever, location doesn't matter or anything like that, but I want to be happy and happy with what I'm doing, and I know that acting makes me happy, so doing that no matter where will make me happy. Realistically, I see myself broke in New York, still trying to be on Broadway or be in a movie, realistically in 10 years, but I also realistically like to think things are going to take me elsewhere, and I'm not going to be pounding the pavement for too long. Carrying so much baggage all the time is just gonna make your back sore. It's gonna make things not as easy, and acting is that way for me to leave baggage behind.
Stand by me. about whenever.